Hello everyone, welcome back to Programming and More YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn React by making a simple snake game using React. This is the final output of the website. This is how the game looks. When the snake eats the food, its length increases, so its score. The user can navigate the snake by using the arrow keys. When the snake eats itself, then it dies. Also, when it hits the walls, then also it dies. So without any delay, let's get started. The first step is to create a React app using Create React App. So let us see how to install Create React App. The command to install Create React App is npm space I space dash g Create React App. Don't forget this hyphen g because we have to install the Create React App globally, and press enter. This will install the package Create React App for us. The installation is completed. Now we can use the Create React App to create a new app with name Snake. Okay, it is showing that the package.json is missing. Okay, there is some conflict. That is because I have tried to install that previously, so let me delete that. Here it is, the folder. Let me delete this. Yes. Now let us try once again. Yeah, now we can see that it is creating an app. I'm skipping this part. It should look something like this while installing. Now our React app is created successfully. You should see something, a screen something like this after running the command successfully. Now let us go to our application folder, which is the name which we gave here, which is snake in my case. Now cd snake. Now to start the development server, run the command npm start. This will start our development server at port number 3000. While it starts the development server, let me open the code editor. After the development server has started, a browser window will be opened in your default browser, and it should look something like this. This is the basic React app which we get after running the command create React app. Now let us go to the code editor and see what all files we got by running that command. We got three folders and two files. The first one is node modules, which we get for every npm project. The next one is public folder, in which the main file of the public folder is index.html. So we don't need all of this. Let me delete everything. Okay,
Now let us go to the src folder. We don't need anything inside src folder, so let me delete the folder and create it again. Now let me create the src folder again. And inside src folder, we need one more JavaScript file. This is must, which is index.js. The name also should be the same, index.js. Let me create it. And it should have an import statement with import React from React. This should be must. And one more thing, import React DOM from this one, React DOM. These two import statements are must inside the index.js file. And one more statement is must and should, which is if we open the public index.html inside the public folder. Let me scroll down and we can see a div with id root. It is not necessarily a div with id root, it can be anything, let's say app or something. For now let us keep it the same root. We should target this inside the index.js file and we can render any components. We should specify the component which should be rendered from index.js file. So let us do it. For that, React DOM dot render of, if we need we should target that document dot get element by ID of root, and we should specify the React component. For now let us keep it as a h1 tag. Let us say hello. Okay, let us say welcome to programming and more. Let me enable toggle word wrap, and I have kept my autosave checked, so the server will be restarted whenever I make changes. So let us go to the browser and see the output. Let me refresh this tab. Okay, now everything has gone. It is restarting. Okay. Sorry, we made a mistake here. The component should be the first argument to React DOM dot render. So let us paste it in the beginning. And now it should work properly. Let me remove all the unnecessary tags and comments. We don't need this one also. And we don't need the fav icon. We don't need this. Okay. Yes. Okay. Now the server has restarted and we can see the changes in the browser. Let me open the browser and refresh the tab. Yes, now we can see this h1 tag appearing in the browser.
So you might be wondering, at this point, you might be wondering, how can I use a h1 tag, which is HTML element, inside a .js file, which is JavaScript file? Basically, these are known as JSX expressions. We can use them in the React and React files. Basically, how React works is, React deals with components. We can create components in two ways. One is using classes and other one is using functions. In this video, I am going to tell how to create React components which we can reuse them wherever we want using classes. So without any further delay, let us create our first class component. So let me, to make things clear, let me make one folder called components inside src folder. Inside the components folder which I created just now, let me create one file named, let us say, home, and the extension of the file should be .js, which is JavaScript file. Now the first statement inside every JavaScript file should be importing React from the package name is React. You can also import the component as well, which is not a default export, so we have to put it inside curly brackets, whereas React is something, it is a default export, so it is not required to keep curly brackets for React. Now let us create one class named home and which inherits from the component which you have imported just now. And at the ending of the file, we have to create a default export. It might not be default, but we have to create this export. Let me make it default, export default home. That means when we include import state, import home in another files, then our home class will be exported there. That's why we have to keep export here, export statement here. So the must and should method of any React component is render. This render method should return a JSX expression. Let us say h1 tag which we have from the index.js. Let me copy it and paste it. It can be simply a HTML element, or it can be a combination of different HTML elements. So first let us see how to do it, how to return a single HTML element. We can simply do it by adding it inside the render method just after the return statement, like this. So to see the results, we have to import the home.js in the index.js, and we have to pass it to the render method of React DOM. So let me import home from, it is, we can see it is, the home is inside the components folder. So let me specify the path as /components/home, like this. Now let us render the home component, which we can do like this, which is by
means it is a self-closing tag with the class name, which is home. Now, let us open the command prompt, and we can see it is compiling. Let us wait for it to compile, and let us refresh the browser to see changes. Now we can see it has compiled successfully. Let us now open the browser and refresh. But actually there will not be any change because we have used the same text. So let us, just to verify, let us change the text in the home.js. Let us say snake game. No. Now let us refresh. You see, now you can see, we can see the changes here. That means that this is working. Now let us quickly see how to render, how to return two elements like this. Suppose we want to render one more p tag, which says this is a game made by React. Just after including one more element, we can see some error, which says that JSX expressions must have single parent element. That means we have to, one simple way is we have to add these elements inside a div tag, means we have to wrap them inside a root div, or now it is fine, or we can simply use an empty tag, means it is a React fragment. We have to do it like this. This is a React fragment. Now we can return as many elements as we like. So let us see if this works. Yes, it is working. Now let us see how we can create routes inside React. To create routes, we need React Router DOM. So let us install it by opening our command prompt. And let me navigate to our project folder. And we have to install one package named React Router DOM, which is React-router-dom. I want to install a specific version, which is 5.3.0, and hit enter to install it. Let us wait for it to install. And now the installation is complete. Let us go to the code editor, and inside components, let me create one more component named routing.js, and it is going to import React from React, and one more package, import React router DOM. Okay, not React router DOM exactly, import browser router and route from React router DOM. Import browser router comma route from React router DOM. Observe one thing, these are not default exports, so I have put them inside curly brackets. Now we need, let us create class routing which inherits react.component, and let us make it a default export here, export by including this line, export default routing. Now this needs a render method and a return statement with a browser tag component, browser router component. Inside browser router, we should have routes. Let us create our home route. Route and its attribute should be path. I'm keeping it forward slash, which is for root or home. And the component we have to, other attribute we have to specify is component. Okay. So we have to import that component which we want to add as a route here. So let us import home now. Import home from dot slash home. It is in the same folder. Notice inside JSX expression, we can use JavaScript code. We can write JavaScript code by simply adding curly brackets. So inside curly bracket, whatever we write is code. So we can specify the component by simply adding the name of that component inside curly brackets like this. And one more thing we have to do, we have to import routing here. Instead of home, it should be routing. We should render routing like this. Now let us go to the browser and see which component is getting rendered. Let me refresh it. If I open the command prompt, it is still compiling. Let us wait for the compilation to be done, and we can see that it is failed. Browser router is not exporting. Okay. That is a typo. Let me correct it. It is browser router, not, I have missed one S. So let me correct it. Yes, now it is perfect. Let us go and check. Yeah, now it has recompiled successfully. So let me open the browser again and see for the changes. And we can see that the home route is now the actually home component is actually rendering on the home route. So let us create one more component which is named game. So let me create game.js and let us do the same thing, that is import React and create one class, and let us specify that it is going to be the default export. Let me do it quickly. Now let us return in the render method, let us return one h1 tag with contents as game, just to notice difference. Okay. Right. So let us see if it is compiling again or not. Now it is showing that has compiled successfully. So let us go to the browser and refresh. Yes, the home route is rendering correctly. Let us check if, okay. We have to specify that to render something, one more component when, okay, let me show you. let us import km from /km, and let us create one more route. Sorry, whose path is going to be /git, and component is going to be the game. Now let us see what we'll get when we visit the game route. Home route is still the same. Now let us go to the game route. We can see that both of the routes, the home component and the game component, both are being rendered. Let us see why. Because there is one /, inside game also. So this /, is matching with this all this, and so it is rendering home. Suppose let us say we keep here home like this, and now see, only the game is rendering because only /, game is matching in that case. So if we still want to use a single /, that is for home, we should specify here exact. That means it is, if the route name is exactly /, then only render, it will render the that particular component. In this case it is home. So let us go and see how it is rendering. And in the home it is rendering only home. Now let us go to the game. You can see it is only rendering the game, right, the way how we wanted to work. Now to link these two routes, one thing we can do is using an anchor tag. But remember, when we click on an anchor tag, means when I click on a link, then the window gets refreshed again. But we don't want it in React because we want our application to be a single page. That means we do not want to reload the page again and again. And one more advantage with React is it will not update the entire document object model again and again. It will maintain one separate copy of it, which is known as virtual DOM, and it will compare the virtual DOM with the real DOM and update only the necessary changes to real DOM. So performance wise, React will increase the performance of our application. So we have to link two pages in React, we have to use one component called link. So let us go to the home and add one link there. Before adding the link, we have to import the link from React router DOM. So now let us see here that here we add one link, name is play game, let us say play game, and here link, the attribute should be 2, so 2. Notice one thing, and the routing in the browser router, for route we have path attribute, whereas in the home, in the link, for link it should be 2, not path. Don't confuse between this and that. So now let us go to the home route. Okay, let me refresh. Yes, now we can see one link. When we click that, we will be, the game route, we'll visit the game route, but notice the page is not reloading again. That's what we want. So this is how we can link two pages in React. Now that we are done with linking our two pages, that is homepage and the game page. Now let us try to design the game board. So for that, let us divide the game board into 19 by 19 squares, or anywhere you like, or any shape you like, as you like. To make it simple, I'm going to stick to 19 by 19 squares. So let us design it in HTML first. So let me go to the game.js file. And instead of rendering simply one h1 tag, we are rendering, let us render one div with class, let us say game container. Okay, inside this div, let us render the smaller squares. That means I told that we are going to divide the game board into 19 by 19 squares. So we have to render each square. So for that, we can use a loop simply. To make it simple, means to make code a little bit clear, I'm going to call that smaller squares as a tile, and I'll make in separate component for each tile. So let me create one file named tile.js, and here also we'll do the same, import React from React class tile extends React.component, and we'll specify this as our default tile. Okay, now let us specify the render method. Render will have return statement. Let us simply return one div with some styling. Okay, styling in React we can do in many ways. So in this example, I'm going to show how to use inline styles in React. So one thing you should observe is, in React the class attribute we have to specify as class name. Like previously I used class, but it is better to use class name instead of class. Okay, now let us go with the class name as game tile, and let us provide the style as let us provide the inline CSS to the style attribute. In React we have to specify styles. If we want to specify as inline styles, we have to specify it as an object, right? So let us see how we can do it. Okay, for this we have to maintain the state of the type, right? So let me quickly create the constructor of this class. So what is props here? Props are extra attributes to the component. Once I'll show you in detail next. For now, let us just add it. Now our class is going to have one state object. and it is going to have one style object with aspect ratio let us give it aspect ratio of 1 and let us give it float left. Notice wherever we have hyphen we have to use camel casing in CSS. This should be style object, and here we have to pass on that this dot state dot style. Okay, so these properties will be passed on to this. In a minute I'll show what exactly is props and state, but why should we use them I'll show you, but for now let us go to the game.js file, and here we have to use one loop to render those 19 by 19 squares, right? So we need some JavaScript code. As I told you earlier, to add JavaScript code inside JSS expression we need curly brackets, so let me add them, and inside the curly brackets we can simply use JavaScript code. So yes, let us maintain the state of this game as well. I'll show you, okay, or else we'll do it later. So for now let us use let us do it now itself. So this will also have a constructor with props, and let us initialize the base class also. Now this will have a state of let us store the state of our game using one matrix. Matrix means a 2D array actually. So let us initialize it with empty matrix, right? And now we want the size of this array to be 19 by 19. So let us do one thing. Let us create one method, getDerivedState from props, and it will take props and state as argument. And let us make this game matrix here, where I equals 0, I less than 19, I plus plus. Let us create one more array and for where j equals 0, j less than 19, j plus plus, temp2 dot push of 0, then we'll push temp2 to temp, temp dot push of temp2, right? Now we need one more information, that is the body of the snake. So if we have to render different colors, right? If the for snake body we have to render one color, for the game matrix for the game board alone there should be one color. So let us start the snake, let us add an array, the body of the snake as an array like this, and at the starting let us initialize it with let's say 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2. And I'll shortly explain what this is. Actually, our game matrix is a 19 by 19 2D array, right? So this 1, 1 means 1, 1 means that is game matrix of 1 of 1. So our game matrix of 1 of 1 will be, suppose let's say 1. If any element of our game matrix is 1, then we can say that at that location snake's body is there. So we can show a different color. I'll show you by rendering this. After once I render, then you can easily understand. Now, yes, after pushing this, what we have to do is, now if means now we are pushing zeros into 19 by 19 array. So now we have to push ones wherever the means for every element of the snake body. See, now the snake list is there in the state. So state dot snake list dot map method I'm going to use, map of I. Now let us say where x equal to I of 0 and y equals I of 1, right? Now for every snake body, for every element in snake body, we have to make, means the first element we have to take, suppose let's say 1, 1, the first element of the snake body. 1, 1 means x is 1 and y is also 1. That means temp of 1 of 1 is 1. So that way we are keeping track of the snake. Means we'll render a different color that I'll show in a while. Now let us return the new state, game matrix temp, right? Now we have to render this game matrix, right? So let us have let us define one function. Means to be clear, let us call it render game matrix. Render game matrix equals, let us use an arrow function. So it is going to return 19 by 19 tiles. So let us see how to do it. So for every element of game matrix, means that means for every row of game matrix, let us call it row. So for every row of game matrix, now in every row, for every tile in that row, let us return one tile component with color prop. I told that I'm going to explain what is prop, so I'll show you. This is what a prop means, right? From here we are passing information to this component, like how we pass to a tag, like how we pass href to a tag, the same way. So that is what a prop means. So our tile component is going to have one prop color. So means whenever it gets that information, let us add it to state. So let's do that here by simply using the static get derived state from props. Now you might have getting some idea that you know, the get derived state from props is used to update the state based on the information which the component is getting from the props, right? So the object which we return in this method will be means it will be treated as the state and it will be updated. So let us in the tile.js let right. Let us update it. Let us update the style, right? Now let us update the style, which is background color. We only background color is left, which is props.color. This way we can access the props, right? So see here, if any element of game matrix is zero, means this ternary operator will return the second one, that is light gray will be returned. Zero means there is no snake, means zero means it indicates game board. One means one indicates snake body, right? So one returns blue, zero returns light gray. That means our snake color will be blue, our game board color will be light gray, right? Okay, this is our render game matrix method for now. Means after we have to update it when we once we do once we add generating food, which we'll do later. So this is our render game matrix for now, right? So now let us go to the render method of our game component, and let us call this this dot render game matrix. We'll render the game matrix here, sorry, like this, right? And one thing we have to do is we have to specify the style for the game container, right? Also for tile. Okay. So let us create one CSS file. Let's say that it is game container something, game container.css, and let us style the game tile whose width is going to be 26 pixel, let us say 26 pixel, and one more thing we have to style, which is game container also, dot game container. Let us say its width is 500 pixel. This simple calculation, 26 into 19 is roughly 500. So, and to align it properly, I'm going to give it margin auto and text align center. Right. I think this should work for now. Let us go to the browser and see. First, let us see if it is compiled or not. We can see that it has failed to compile. The reason is style is not defined in game.js. So means I've forgotten to import tile. Let me do it. Import tile from dot slash tile, right? Now let us open the browser and refresh it. That is the previous error. Okay, here in the line number 14 of tile.js there is some error. Let us go there, right? Tile.js. Okay, it is not static, it is state. Okay, now let us go. Okay, now it has compiled. Let us go to the game and refresh. But we cannot see anything. Why? Let us go to the home route. Yes, we can see this. Okay, okay. There might be some error. Okay. We cannot see anything because we have not imported this CSS. So let us import it in the game. In the game.js component, import dot slash game container dot CSS. To import a CSS file in React, we can do it simply by an import statement. Now let us refresh. Okay, means it is taking some time to load because it is compiling. Let us wait for it to compile. Yes, now let us refresh and see for changes. Still we cannot see anything. Let us see our render matrix in the game.js component. This dot render game matrix. Right. Okay. Let us inspect. Why? In the ID root, game container is being rendered, and we can see this also. Okay, the height. Okay, now I understood. Let us give inside the game container. Let us give here to the game container. Let us give it aspect ratio of 1. Let us try. Still. Okay, game container is loading perfectly. But the height of the game tile is 0. Let us see. What is the problem? Okay. Let us go to the tile.js. Let us go to the tile.js. Yes. And here we have already specified our aspect ratio to be 1. Okay, let us try specifying its height here. Height 26 pixel. Let us refresh now. Okay, now we can see. But float left is not getting applied. Okay, then. Okay, that is because this one we are not rendering, means we are not returning these properties here. Now it will work. That is, yes, now it is working as we expect. See, it is now. Let me explain it clearly for you. This is a 19 by 19 2D matrix which contains zeros and ones as its elements. If it is a 1, then it is a part of a snake, means it is a part of snake's body. If it is 0, then it is game bot, right? See, in the game.js, at the beginning, means this get derived state from props is called okay, first, yes, first the constructor is called, so this dot state will be updated with this. Means the state will have an empty game matrix, and it will have this one as a snake list. Then our get derived state from props will be called, and our game matrix will be filled like this, right? First it will be filled with zero, all zeros, then then it will be updated with ones depending on the state or snake list, right? This is render.game matrix, which is simple. If there is a zero, then the color will be light gray. If element of game matrix is one, the color will be blue. Simple, right? So we have this static snake, but what we want is, let's say for every 100 millisecond the snake should move. We want the snake to be moving, right? So we have to update the snake body. For that, let us use, means we can do it in the game component also, or we can create one more component. Let us call it snake.js. Let us do import React from React, and let us define the class snake extends React.component. This is going to the render method will have return null statement because there is nothing to return here. Only we have to update let us have default export default snake, right? Okay, let us import this in our game.js. import snake from /snake, and let us call here, right? Okay, now what we'll do is let us create one method called let's say change snake body, something like that. Or else let us do it in the game.js itself. Let me delete the snake.js. Okay, and delete it from here, right? And let us under the constructor, let us create one method called, let's say, game tick, right? Let us create it here, game tick equals one function. Let us create one empty array, and let us push the snake body, every item of the snake list to this by using the simple map method. Then what we'll do is let us say, suppose you player has pressed arrow up key, right? Then the snake's head position should be means the y position of the snake's head should be means we should reduce it by one, right? Every means for every game tick, right? So to maintain that means to maintain the increment, let us use increment in our state. Let us say it to be 0, 1 comma 0. That means for every, let us say for every 100 millisecond, we'll add 1 comma 0 to the snake's head board, snake's head, right? Okay. Now inside this game tick function, let us create new increment, where new increment equals this dot state dot increment, right? Now let us create new x, where new x equals this dot state dot snake list of 0 plus new increment of 0. This is new x, and new y equals this dot state dot snake list of 0 of 1, means basically y coordinate of the head, plus new inc of 1. This we have to do. Now let us see, means now for now let us simply move the snake, which we can do by unshifting the body, that is adding one element at the beginning of the array, right? By body of 0, okay, which is, sorry, with new x percent 19 comma new y percent 19 to make sure that it does not exceed the array bounds, right? That means we are adding one head and we have to remove one tail, right? So let us remove tail, which we can do with body dot pop, right? Simple. So basically we are adding one element at the beginning and we're cutting one at the end, so the snake's body length remains same, right? This we are doing. This is game tick. And yes, and we have to call this game tick every, let us say, 100 millisecond. So for that, let us make use of component did mount. That is, it will be called only once when we means the first time when we visit the page. This will be called. Let us say this dot is mounted to be true, and let us say window dot fn interval equals set interval with the function as this dot game tick, right? Not an arrow function. It is this dot game tick comma the time, which is 100, let us say 100 milliseconds, and let us see how it works, right? Okay, body dot pop, and we have to set the state in here, which is snake list comma body. What this does is this, it will take this body this object as an argument, and it will compare with the state. If there are any changes, it will update, and only this component will be re-rendered, right? Let us see what is happening in our browser. Okay, but it has failed to compile. Line number 20 of game.js, snake list is not defined. Okay. Okay, by mistake here I kept comma, but it is dot. Now let us see. Still it failed to compile. Line number 24 also, snake list is not defined. Line number 24. Okay, sorry. This dot set state. Okay, here it should be colon, not comma. Sorry. And I have to remove this snake because we are not including. Okay. Now we should, yes, we should see a working snake, moving snake, right? Basically, what we are doing is we are adding one more, we are adding one at the beginning of the snake, just before the snake's head, and we are cutting down its tail, right? So its length is remaining same and it appears like it is moving. Now let us go to the code and let us set some keyboard event listeners, right? Let us do it in the component read mode because it will be called just before rendering the component, right? So let us call keyboard as document or body, which I'll get as document.querySelector of body, right? Now we'll add one event listener, which is keyboard.addEventListener of keyDown. Then a callback function with event as parameter. Let us say var new increment here. So if e dot key is arrow up, then we have to make new increment as -1, 0. That means we have to reduce the column number, sorry, we have to reduce the row number, and the column number remains same, right? Else if e dot key is equal to arrow down, we have to do the opposite. That is, we have to increase the column number, increase the row number, but the column number remains same. Else if e dot key is equals arrow left, then new increment should be, means now the column number, the row number should be same, and we should reduce the column number. And the last case is else if e dot key equals arrow right, new increment equals 0, 1, right? Okay, and let us set state after this dot set state. of okay in some cases there might not means there might not be any key expressed, so we should not we should not set the state to be with undefined, right? That is, let's say that let us initialize it with minus one first of all. So if new INC is not equals minus one, then only we are going to set state, right? Increment as our new INC, right? This is what we want. Now let us open the browser and see. Let's see, first of all, it is compiled or not. Let us see. Yes, it has compiled with warnings, but okay, let us ignore them and see. Okay, but when I press the key, okay, yes, now it is working. See, when I press the key, the snake is moving perfectly fine. This is how we want, right? Now we want to keep track of means whether if the whether the snake eats itself or if it hits the walls, right? Now let us add it. Now to see if you know if the user has pressed a wrong key, that is means if the snake is going left and the user has pressed the right again, right, then the snake cannot move backward, right? The snake can only change its direction which is not opposite to the present direction of travel, right? Means basically what I'm telling is the snake cannot crawl backwards, right? Yes, we have to check for that. Simply, we can do it by using one if statement. If new INC of 0 plus this dot state dot increment of 0 is 0. That means both are opposite in sign, means they are opposite in direction as well. Or in the other direction, this new increment of 1 plus this dot state dot increment of 1 is equal to 0, right? If both are satisfied, then of course we should not do anything because the snake cannot crawl backwards, right? So that is it. Now the other thing is yes, means we have to check if the snake moves out of the board or eats itself. So for that, let us add one more thing in our state, that is the game over state. Let us call it, let's say, game over. Simply game over, and let us set it to false because initially we want it to be true, the game to be running, right? So in our render method, let us add one ternary operator. To add it, we need curly brackets because ternary operator is JavaScript code, right? We can do it like this. So this dot state dot game over, if the game is over, okay, let us do it here or inside the game container. Let us do it because it will be centered there. right? This dot state dot game over, game over, otherwise this one, right? Okay. Now let us see if there is an error. Yes, there is. Okay, there should not be semicolon, I think. Yes, now it seems to work fine. Now let us first add the walls case means when the snake goes out of the wood. That is, we have to calculate the new x and new y. If we find them to be out of the wood, then simply we have to set the state means the game over to be true, right? Now let us go. And inside this component in mount only, means in the keyboard event listener, we have to find if new x is greater than or equal to 19, or means we have only 19 right here. So let us check if, okay, first let us calculate new x and new y. Here, where new x equals this dot state dot snake list of 0 plus new anc and new y equals this dot state dot snake list of 0 of 1 new inc of 1. Okay, here it should be new inc of 0, right? Okay, now it is correct. Now okay, we should add this before setting the state. If new x is less than 0 or new x is greater than 18 or new y is less than 0 or new y is greater than 18, let us set the state and return, or else here let us keep else. Let's see, right? If this dot set state of game over true, right? So let us see if it is compiled or not. And yes, it seems to be compiled, but let us refresh again. Yes, this did not work because we have to add this in this here in the game tick function. We have to add this, not in the keyboard event listener, right? Because we want to check this every 100 milliseconds, right? Here we should keep one else. Now it should work. Let us see if it has compiled. Yes, it has compiled. Now, yes, now we can see that one time it is, when it hits, it is showing game over. Okay, but let us add one button for restarting game. So let us create one method to which says restart game equals this dot set state of game over to be false, and we have to start the snake list from the beginning, right? This one here, like this. Now let us add one React fragment here, because we are adding one more . Let us keep it inside H1. Anyway, we like, let us keep it inside P. Right? P, and then let us add one button. Restart, and let us give on click equals. We have to give JavaScript function. Let us give it this dot restart game, right? Now let us see how it works. Let me refresh. Yes. Now we can see restart, and when we click that, the game is getting restarted. That is all we want. And one more thing we want is the score, which we can do here. H1. Okay, not like this. Inside H1, this one quote, right? Which is this dot state dot snake list dot length minus 3, right? Because initially we are having length as 3, so the score will start from 0, right? Now when the snake hits the walls, then the game is getting over. Yes, but one thing, here we also want the increment should be the same. Increment should be 1, 0, right? Otherwise, yes, it will be difficult to control. Yes, now one more thing we have to add is to set the game state to be false, to be game over to be true when the snake eats itself, right? So let us do that. We can simply do, means we can add one more condition to this if statement. If condition, which is this dot state dot snake list dot filter of I, let us say if the result of the it is greater than 0, right? It is not 0. Length I, let us filter. Hence we are checking if the head coincides with, means if we are checking if any of its previous body is coinciding with its new head, and we'll set its state based on that, right? Okay. Now what we are doing here is, if it will filter all of the common parts to its new head to its old body, including its old head, and it will return its length. So if the length is not 0, that means, suppose let's say it is 1, that means its new head is
coinciding with any of its older body, right? So then we have to set the game over to be true, right? That is what we are doing. But we cannot visualize it right now because the length of the snake is only 3, so it should increase. So let us see it after creating food, right? Food we can do in one simple way. Means till now the elements of the game matrix are 0 or 1, but we can set any of it randomly to be 2 and we can think of it as food. This simple way, so let us do it. To make it clear, I want to create one more method called generate food. This is going to return this is going to return two random integers below 18, right? Or below 19. Parse int of map.random times 18 and let me call it again. Yes, so we'll get a new food position, right? Let us say that we want to call food, we want to change the position of the food with frequency which is smaller than the frequency by which we are changing the snake position by 4 times, right? Suppose, let's say that. Right, for that let us create one variable here, t count, or anything you want, and set it to 0. And in the game tick, let us increment it. Here we can increment it. T count equals t count plus 1 percent 40. Right. So if the t count is let's say 39, then we'll generate new food, right? Okay, let us in the state let us give one new food. Let us add food. Let us say that it is at 15, 15. And in the game tick, and one more thing we want is food visible, right? We have to use is food visible boolean, and let us set it to be true. And you'll see why we need it, right? Inside our game tick, inside this else statement, we have many things to see, so let me keep it in curly braces and let me let me get food from the state, this dot state dot by this dot state dot food, right? Now also is food visible, ifv, this dot state dot is food visible. Now what we have to do is, if count equals 39, then only we have to generate new food, right? Then only we have to generate new food. If count equals 39, let us say food equals
this dot generate food, right? That's it. Now, and we have to set I of v to be true, right? We want it to be true. Means suppose we'll make I of v to be false when the snake eats the food, right? We don't want it to be shown. But once in a while, we want this food to be appearing again, right? We want the food to be appearing again, so we have to do this. Okay. Now, this we have to do inside game tick function, right? Okay. And yes. Now we can do one thing. We can add if body of zero means if the head coincides with food. If head does not coincide with food, then only we'll pop out the tail. Otherwise, means if in the case it coincides, then only we have to cut its tail, right? Means if it coincides, not it's not needed to cut its tail, right? Else means if it coincides, we have to set IFV to be false. Now we will set the state here. We should set the state food to be food. Is food visible to be I of V? And what else? And I think this is right. Now in the or here in the get derived state from props, before the snake we have to make temp of this dot state dot food of zero and this dot state dot food of one to be two here, right? And inside the render game matrix, if this dot state dot is food visible if this dot state dot is food visible and t equals to, we have to return tile with some other color indicating food, right? Let us say let it be red here. Now let us see what happens. We can see that there are some problems while compiling. So we have only one, which is in the 42nd line of game.js file, count is not defined, it seems. Let us check. Let us go to the 42nd line. Okay, it is not count, instead t count. So I think okay. Still problems are there. It did not compile again, I guess. Let us wait for it to compile again. Okay, there seems to be some errors. Let me refresh it again. And yes, in the game.js line number 77, state is not defined. It seems. Let us go to the line number 77. Okay, it is not this dot state actually, because here already we are passing state here. this is not required, right? Simply we can use state. Yes, and so now let us refresh it. Okay. Now there is one error, right? The color still is blue. That means okay. The color of food is also blue. So let us fix it. Okay, I understood why. Okay, if t equals to, we have to use this ternary operator here. Let me clear this. And here, let us use one ternary operator. If this dot state dot is food visible, let us show red. Otherwise, let us show it light gray, right? Yes. So now let us try. Now we cannot see the food at all. Let us quickly fix it. That means is put visible member of state is false. Okay. That is because here it should be body of 0 of 1, not body of 0 of 0, because it will be always, means always the else statement will be executed, so always the if is showing false, so we are not seeing food. Now let us try again. Okay, still. Okay, this is also not working. Cannot perform a React state update on. Okay. Okay, we made one mistake here. Yes, this should not be here actually. Let us cut this and let us paste it here, right? And here, where new INC equals this dot state dot increment, right? And let us remove this. Yes, now let us see. Yes, now it is working. Okay, now the issue is with rendering food, right? The problem is here we are doing body.pop again, this is not needed. So let me remove that and let us see if we can see. Okay, let us refresh. Okay, here there is some error, I think. By mistake. No. So let us, I think this IFE is also not required here. Let us keep one, let us keep it inside brackets. Now let us see. Yes, now it is working. Yes, now it is working. See, the score is also automatically updating. the errors which we can see on our console, we can ignore them. They are not big errors. Okay, but one thing is, when the snake eats itself, means the game is not getting ended. We have to fix that. See, now the snake can pass through itself, right? We have to fix that. Let us see. That is not working because here it should be I of 1, not I of I. It is a typo. Now let us see. Yes, now when I try to eat myself, then the game has ended. Now see, everything is working. See, so and this is your snake game which is made in React, right? So let us see if your home is working or not. Yes, we can see when we click on play game, the game is loading, right? That is what we want. And please write a comment if you do not understand anything, because this is a long video, right? I have to shorten some things down. So please write in the comments if you do not understand, and please subscribe for more updates. Please like the video if you really like it. Thank you.